Hello and welcome to yet another YouTube video here on this channel. In today's video, we will dive into applications that can help you run your life and organize your whole life. And none of these applications are Obsidian or Notion, which a lot of you might be familiar with. The first app we have on this list is called Superlists, which is from the founders of Wunderlist, which Microsoft bought, and it is now Microsoft To Do. And inside of here, we have different lists. In my case, I have my social media ideas here as well. So do someday, I have a here to watch list I have here. You can have lists and you can have sub-lists within those lists. They also allow for team plans. So this, if you are in a smaller team like I am, this could be a great way for you to organize a lot of your work together with your team, which is really a really cool thing for a to-do list application. It works best if you are on a smaller team, because this is basically a to-do list application and it is really, really new. So it has some minor bugs, nothing that have ended up like breaking the app or making it unusable. So it is not like a deal breaker, but it has some minor ones. So we have what's called selections, which is basically what this YouTube video here is. And we have lists within those selections. So if I jump into one of them, I can actually add notes here. And I can assign it to someone, or I can change the tag, I can open the list, or I could give it a due date here as well. They have some AI capabilities, like every single application, but in order to use those, you have to be on the pro plan, and we will go into the pricing a little later. You can share this list as well, and just in general, it is like a really easy to use application and great for smaller teams. You have the ability to add notes here as well, and the notes are block based. We have basic markdown inside of here as well, and you can use backslash to actually put things here. So I can add sub lists within here or sub tasks. And they show up here as well. So it is a beautifully designed application, which I like a lot. And even the subtasks can actually have subtasks. So you could nest these however much you want to. But overall, I think that this is best for people who just want something simple to organize their life and don't want to spend too much time building a system and figuring out an application. This is basically a list maker with tasks and subtasks and the ability to take notes. For the pricing plan, you have a free plan which gives you 5 shared lists, 5 collaborators per list, and that is the personal for $10 each month or $96 each year, which comes in at $8 per month. You get unlimited private and shared lists, up to 25 collaborators per list. You get the AI, you get even more AI, all integrations like Slack or Figma, 500 megabyte uploads plus 25 gigs of storage. So that's what you get on the pro plan. And that is, again, for the personal. They have team plans as well if you wanted to use this as a team. I really like this application because of the simplicity, and I've considered it for my project management since I now have people working with me from time to time. So it is something I am considering. Because these tasks can actually be assigned as well, which just gives you everything you need inside of a project management application for a really small team, which is what I have. So that is the first one. The next app we are going to talk about is actually another to-do list application. This is Timestripe. Timestripe is scary because Timestripe shows you a lot, but you have spaces here, which are basically workspaces. You have what's called horizons, hours, days, weeks, months, years, because the way this application works is that it isn't like the other to-do list applications you might have tested out. This one is a little bit different because this just doesn't want to be a place where you organize your basic daily to-dos. It wants you to focus on your life goals. So I have an example I have used every time I've made a video about this, and that is that my main goal in life is to become a professional footballer. It isn't, because I suck at football. So I will probably just end up watching the Euros and never playing in them. But for the sake of this video, let's say I wanted to become a footballer. So my goal here is to go on a trial this month, get signed by the end of the year, and become a footballer by the end of my life. That is basically how this application works. And to do that, I have to exercise for half an hour each day. But we also do have the ability to calendar block things. If you ever wanted to do that, you can. Inside of here, you can add description, which is basically a way for you to take notes. It doesn't work with Markdown, but you can still take notes into here. You can add sub-goals or images and files here as well if you wanted to do that. So I will just add a couple for the sake of this video. Press OK. And if I open this up again, you can see that I have sub-goals. I can drag this wherever I want within this day, because it is a daily task, and I can change how long it takes. So you have the ability to do calendar blocking here as well. Or I could jump into the days and I can move it to another day like this. And as you can see, the notes that have, or the task that have notes, has these right here, which shows you that there is something written inside of it. We also have the week view, month view, and the year's view as well. But apart from that, we have boards. Boards are another way for you to organize your different to-dos and notes. So you have the Kanban, you have a reading list template, so you could use this as your reading list, a project plan template, and a Kanban template here as well. This one I actually made myself, I think. But I'm not sure. We have a Kanban template here as well, and we have GTD as well. So you have a bunch of different templates you can actually choose from if you don't want to create your own boards. This is basically another way for you to organize. You have insights here, which doesn't seem to work, and here it is. It just took a second, where you can see how many tasks you have created, done, and updated, and you get a today score as well. So you get a percent active days this year, and you get a bunch of stats as well. So this gives you insights, and this has actually gotten a lot better since the first time I tested it out. You have a gallery. This is basically your templates, and there are a bunch of them for you to choose from if you ever wanted to use templates. And the last one is Climb, which is basically challenges you can take on. So everything from writer block to 75 hard, 7-day plan to organize, prioritize task for productivity. There are a bunch to choose from. Pricing on this is $15 if paid monthly, or $7.50 if paid yearly, or $5 for the 5-year plan. That is in US dollars. If you skip your trial, you get 50% off. So monthly, it is really, really expensive, but the yearly plan is quite good priced. It compares well to the rest of the market, so this is worth it. This probably isn't, but the application overall is really cool, and I love their marketing as well. They're doing such a good job on Twitter, which is now called X. They're doing a good job on X. Next application on the list is actually called amplenote, and amplenote is the best place for your notes, your tasks, and your calendars combined together. They have a graph view which is available on the pro plan. And before we dive into the application, there is one thing I want to mention. So they have this amplenote 2024 supporter drive, which cannot be dismissed. But if we jump into here and look what this is, amplenote has been around for 5, 6 years or so, actually 7 years. And they are burning through money each month, which is something I know is really important for people, that an app can stick around for a long period of time. But what it looks like is that if only half of their personal users upgraded to the pro plan, amplenote could be profitable tomorrow. So that's what they are trying to do. And it seems like they have at least gained some traction with this, but I'm not sure how much. You get a t-shirt and teams as well, where if you were to join the pro plan within, I think it's the 10th of July, so 2 days from now. But basically, how this application works, you have a daily page, you have your notes, and inside of your notes, you can actually add tasks. So let's do markdown like this. Here we have a task, and I could go on and I could add a bunch of tasks. And I could schedule these to tomorrow, both of them, jump into my calendar and go into tomorrow. And they should appear somewhere. Here they actually are, both of them. So I can drag these around. I can make them longer, make them shorter, and play around with this to do calendar blocking. And you also have like you have your tasks here as well. So here I could drag these tasks into my into my calendar like this. So everything from my YouTube video ideas to work tasks, I can just have everything in one place. That's what makes this application so good. It is the fact that you have your tasks, your notes, and everything just in one place. And this is probably the best task management I've seen in any note-taking app. So if your life revolves around tasks, then this might be the application for you. Pricing wise, you get far with the personal free plan, but for $5.85 each, $84 each month, if billed annually, you get all the benefits from here, and you get a graph view, sidebar, note view, sync, external calendars, 6-color themes, tag sharing for group collaboration, insert table of contents, and file uploads larger than 5 MB. That's the pro plan. Unlimited plan gives you vault notes for client encryption of sensitive content. Publish your notes as web pages and 8-color themes to choose from. This founder app gives you early access. That is basically the main selling point. You also get 2 one-on-one onboarding calls for annual subscribers. This costs you 20, 10, and 584. All of these are billed annually. The next application is probably the priciest one. This will set you back $14 each month if billed annually, or $18 if billed monthly. But this is an outliner application called Tana. Here you can have everything from your tasks inside of databases to your different notes. My social media ideas are inside of here. I can have a list of all of my applications I've played around with, all of my projects, everything I can just have inside of here. And basically the way this works is that it has a today page where you can add things. So let's say I wanted to just add an idea, and this is a social media post, so I can tag it social media post, and it will appear in my social media ideas where I can give it tags and just add it to or give it the properties that it needs. It has things like backlinking, so you can link different notes together, and it probably has the best AI integration I've seen in an outliner application ever. They have what's called AI chat, which allows you to talk to your notes. They have an AI meeting assistant, so if you have a lot of meetings and you are more of a hardcore note taker and a knowledge management person. Is that a word? I don't think it is a word, but we will use it as a word today. But if you're really into personal knowledge management, this might be the best application for you. I think the price is really justified given all of the AI abilities it has. And this is sort of your all-in-one workspace for everything. What I like about this is that it is really easy to capture because it is an outliner, and outliners make it really easy to capture notes. So I can easily just capture a note, but it also allows you to structure whatever you captured through these super tags, is what it is called. And you even have the ability to link different things together. So, for example, I can jump into any type here, or I can jump into Tana here because these are linked together. So I really like that. I, in general, think the application is really, really good, even though it is highly priced. So for you hardcore note takers and productivity people out there, this might be an option. So last application is another simple one. This app is called Tooze, and it is the best place to just write things down. You can have your notes in here. You can have your projects, your tasks in here as well. So if I jump into my today, you can see all of my tasks, and you can see all of the tasks I have done. Basically the way this works is that you have what's called a daily page where you can just write things down. I could actually add tags to this as well because it can be organized with tags, but I have chosen to organize it with lists and sublists. It has a way for you to see it in a split view, so I can see my notes as I am working on something else. I love the split view. You can add images into here as well. You can customize this a little bit to show you the things you want in your home page or sidebar. You have your to-dos here, so I have all of my to-dos here from my different ideas, projects I have, people I want on my podcast. I just have everything inside of here. Really simple application to learn. Basically, the way it works is that you just write things down. I actually did this task, but you just write things down. It is that simple. Similar to superlists, which we touched on earlier, it is a list maker, so you have lists with sublists. But I would say that this offers a little bit more, and it has a little bit more customization as well. I've done a bunch of videos about Tooze because I love the application, so check out one of those if you're interested in diving deeper into it. But if this looks like a cool application, I really recommend it. It is one of my personal favorites, and even though I haven't been able to touch on everything inside of it, it is a really powerful application that also is really fun to use, and it has a graph view as well for those of you who like seeing your notes in a graph. Mine is really, really small, but I've seen some crazy graph views over over on X from this application. Anyways, if you have any questions, do leave them down below and I will try to get to them as soon as I can. Thank you so much for watching today's video.